गुड मॉर्निंग, दिस इज वेणुगोपाल विथ इंग्लिश बुक 5 लेसन 1 गॉड इन द मिरर। चिल्ड्रन, यू रिमेंबर द प्रीवियस क्लास वी कंप्लीटेड द स्टोरी गॉड इन द मिरर। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्वेश्चंस एंड अदर एक्सरसाइजेस। देर इज अ टास्क फॉर समेटिव असेसमेंट गिवन इन पेज नंबर 8 ऑफ योर टेक्स्ट बुक। इन बिट ए, व्हाट हैव यू अंडरस्टूड? There are some questions given there under the bit A. Just we'll be discussing the questions. We are not going to write any answers on the board because this key will be sent to you through WhatsApp after the completion of the discussion of these exercises. So first question is, who was Tenali Ramakrishna? Look at the question itself. Just remove this word, the question word, and write Tenali Ramakrishna, and then write was here. Then you write the remaining part of the answer. Tenali Ramakrishna was a great writer of funny poems. If you look at the first page of the lesson, the first sentence itself is the answer, okay? Like this, you have to learn how to prepare answers for the questions, children. Tenali Ramakrishna was a great writer of funny poems. Question number 2. What did Tenali Ramakrishna say to the king during a conversation? You remember, children, what did Tenali Ramakrishna say to the king during a conversation? Turn to page 1. One day during a conversation, Tenali Ramakrishna said to the king, "Your Majesty, people always lie whenever they get a chance." In such cases, children, you should be very careful when writing the answers, because the answer is given there in the quotation marks. But that means in direct speech. We have to write in indirect speech for such type of questions, because look at the question. You can write, during a conversation, Tenali Ramakrishna told King Krishnadevaraya that people always lie when they got a chance. Like this, without using quotation marks, you have to write the answer in direct speech. This is what we have to learn. This is very important while writing answers for the questions in English. Because most of the time you find the paragraphs in the form of conversation between the people. But when you write the answers, you must write like this. This is writing in indirect speech. What is given there in the textbook in the form of lesson is always in direct speech. So, Ramakrishna told during a conversation, Tenali Ramakrishna told King Krishnadevaraya that people would always lie when they got a chance. Question number 3. What did Krishnadevaraya challenge Tenali Ramakrishna to prove? So Tenali, King Krishnadevaraya challenged Tenali Ramakrishna to prove the theory that people would always lie whenever they got a chance. What challenge did he give to Ramakrishna, Tenali Ramakrishna? That he should prove the people would always lie whenever they got a chance. Question number 4. What did Tenali Ramakrishna ask the king to prove his theory? He asked for 1,000 gold coins and a year's time to prove his theory. What did he ask for? He asked for 1,000 gold coins and a year's time to prove his theory. Question number 5. What did Tenali Ramakrishna do with the money? With the money of 1,000 gold coins, Tenali Ramakrishna constructed a large palatial and beautiful house. What did he do with that money? He constructed a large palatial beautiful house. Question number 6. Who came to Krishnadevaraya in the disguise of a sage? Who is that man who came to Krishnadevaraya in the disguise of a sage? That is none other than Tenali Ramakrishna himself. So Tenali Ramakrishna came to Krishnadevaraya in the disguise of a sage. What did he tell the king? He told the king that he had a beautiful house for himself and he stayed and prayed there every time. And his devotion had impressed the God. And he told the king that God now and then would appear in one of the rooms of his house like that. And he also told the king to feel free to see the God for himself. This is what that man, Tenali Ramakrishna, who came in the disguise of a sage, told King Krishnadevaraya. Question number 7. Did the two ministers really see the God in the sage's house? No. The two ministers did not see the God in the sage's house. They simply lied. They did not see the God. Question number 8. What did the king see in the sage's house? In the sage's house, the king saw his own image or reflection in a mirror in one of the rooms. Question number 9. How did Tenali Ramakrishna prove that everyone is a liar sometime or the other? How did he prove that? By inviting the king to see for himself that if he had never lied, he would definitely see the God in one of the mirrors or in the mirror which is fixed to one of the walls there in one of the rooms in his house. Thus he proved that everybody is a liar sometime or the other. Okay children, these answers will be set to you. You need not worry that those answers you can copy in your classworks. Now in bit B, write T for true statements and F for false statements. People always lie whenever they get a chance, according to Tenali Ramakrishna. Is it true or false? It's true. Krishnadevaraya had lied several times. No, it's false. Tenali Ramakrishna wanted 1,000 gold coins and 2 years' time to prove his theory. False. He wanted only 1 year time. Sentence number 4. Tenali Ramakrishna saw God every day in his new beautiful building. That is also false. According to Tenali Ramakrishna, God is visible to those who had a righteous life and had never lied in their lives. That is true. He had told the king that the God would be visible to those people who had led a righteous life and who had never lied in their lives. These are the true or false statements. Next, in B, bit language in use, grammar part. Using whenever. Look at the sentence given there. Your Majesty, people always lie whenever they get a chance to. In the above sentences, the word whenever means at every opportune moment. At every chance, at every opportune moment. Now rewrite the following pairs of sentences using whenever. One is done for you. Come and meet me if you get time. And come and meet me whenever you get time. So you can combine the sentences or rewrite the sentences using whenever as given in the example. help the needy if you see them suffering. Second one, help the needy whenever you see them suffering. Whenever you see them suffering, like this, you have to write the answers. Third, first one is given as an example. This is the second answer. Third one, get me a blanket if you go to Srinagar. Get me a blanket whenever you go to Srinagar. You remember, you know Srinagar? Where is Srinagar, children? Srinagar is the capital city of Jammu and Kashmir, one of the most beautiful cities in the world. Sentence number four, read this book if you get the time. So, fourth one, read this book whenever you get the time. Sentence number five, bring me some stamps if you go to the post office. Bring me some stamps whenever you go to the post office. So what you have understood from this is, in every sentence, the word if is used, if is a conjunction. And remove that if and write whenever in the place of if, that automatically becomes the answer. Now read these sentences. I, comma, being a king, present participles are ing forms. Introducing phrases. For example, look at these sentences. I, being a king, have never lied. And can never lie. This is a combination of the two sentences given there. You can see, I have been a king for a long time. I have never lied and can never lie. When you combine these two sentences, you get this sentence here. In the same way, look at the second sentence. After taking the money, Tenali Ramakrishna did not appear in the court for that whole year. So, Tenali Ramakrishna took the money. He did not appear in the court for that whole year. Now, rewrite these sentences as shown in the examples above. Change each underlined clause into a phrase that begins with ing form of the verbs in brackets. That's what we are going to write now. She, within brackets, had completed her homework. So, when you write that sentence using ing form, look at these children, having completed her homework, she went out to play. See how this she had completed her homework is changed into another form using ing form of the verb, having completed. In the same way, sentence number two, Mala heard a door click shut and looked out of the window. Hearing a door click shut, Mala looked out of the window. This is how, see, hearing a door click shut. This is how it is changed, the underlined part is changed into ing form of the verbs, beginning with ing form of the verbs. Hearing, this is having. Sentence number 3, he looked terribly worried and boarded the train. Looking terribly worried, he boarded the train. That's how you have to write the answer. Mr. Rao get down from the bus and walked slowly towards his home. Getting down from the bus. How to write the sentence? Fourth sentence. Getting down from the bus, Mr. Rao walked slowly towards his house. Sentence number 5. Ravi changed his dress and slipped under the cars. Changing his dress, Ravi slipped under the covers. Means he hid himself under the blanket. He covered himself with a blanket to sleep. Meena took out a book and started to read it. Taking out a book, Meena started reading it. Taking out a book, Meena started reading it. In the sentence bit C, we word know, read these phrases. Each phrase has two or more adjectives followed by a noun at the end. A beautiful, large, palatial house. But the adjectives in these phrases are not in proper order. Put them in a proper order. Attractive and colorful interiors. A great and beautiful house. Look at the words given below. They are all describing words or adjectives. Now look at this. You have to complete the blanks there in the sentences with the words given there in the yellow box. Shakespeare was a dash dramatist and a poet. Great. What is the answer there? Great. There is a dash mountain near the river. Large mountain. A large mountain. Large means very big. Srinivas was rewarded for his righteous conduct. Righteous means truthful. He built a dash house, a palatial house to live in with all his family members. Fourth answer is palatial. Fifth one, you can see some dash flowers if you visit our garden. Beautiful flowers. Sixth one, the interiors were in attractive designs. Attractive designs. Seventh sentence, the Miss World contest last night was a colorful event. There is a dash reason for Radhika's absence. Certain reason. A clear reason for her absence. Now, syllables and stress. Generally, we find different words having different sounds. Syllables and stress. Where exactly a word is to be stressed there while we pronounce that word, that we should know, and before that we should know the meaning of a syllable. Syllable is a word or a part of a word with at least one vowel sound. Now read these words aloud. This is the meaning of syllable. So every word is divided into syllables. For example, you take it this word, conversation. So we can see that there, how that is divided. See, one vowel sound here, one syllable, another syllable. Four syllables are there, this word, because each and every syllable is a word or a part of a word. For example, you take bat, only one syllable is there. Okay, only one vowel sound is there. This is a one syllable word, single syllable word. This is a four syllable word. For example, you look at this word cricket. Cricket, one is CRI, another one is, see, this is the two syllable words. There are two syllables in this. Okay, chill. Now read these words. You can see that they are attached, engaged in a conversation, affixed, chance, beautiful, situation, disguise, challenge, righteous, attached, conversation. The division of words into several parts help us to pronounce the word easily. The parts that divided are called syllables. See, now we have to divide the remaining words given there above as shown in the examples there. Mark the stress in each word. How the stress is marked there, you can see attached. The apostrophe is kept there on after A. In conversation, it is kept there at S. Like that, you have to stress the, mark the stress in each word after dividing the words into different syllables. And using a dictionary, writing skills, speaking skills and listening skills will be taken up later. Thank you, children. Let us remind you once again that the key for all these exercises, including questions and answers, you will be sent through the WhatsApp. Thank you.